Good morning, students. Welcome to online classes of St. Joseph's Academy. I am Akanksha, your computer teacher. In this video, we will continue our chapter 1, that is computer devices, memory, and storage. These are the topics which we have discussed earlier in our previous video. First is input devices, and the examples of input devices are keyboard, mouse, scanner, microphone, etc. Then we have discussed about output devices, and the examples of output devices are monitor, printer, speaker, and plotter. Next, we are having processing device, and you know that what is processing device? That CPU is the processing device, and the full form of CPU is central processing unit, and we call CPU as the brain of the computer. Next, we have discussed about the data storage units, and then memory chart. We have discussed about the memory chart. Now, according to memory chart, that memory is divided into two parts. Primary memory, we call it internal memory also, and second is secondary memory, which is external memory. So let's see what is primary memory. The primary memory is kept on silicon chips and is fixed to the circuit board. It is also called internal memory. This primary memory is always fixed to the circuit board. Circuit board, which is fixed inside the CPU, and this primary memory is kept on the silicon chips and is fixed to the circuit board. That's why we call it internal memory. We call it also as internal memory. Now further, this primary memory is of two types. First, we have seen that memory have two parts, primary memory and secondary memory. Now this primary memory is also having two parts. This is also of two types. First is RAM. RAM means random access memory. The full form of RAM is random access memory. And what it is? The information stored on this memory is erased when the computer is switched off. And the best example of RAM is a calculator. A calculator is an example of RAM. We can see the numbers as soon as the calculator is on. When the calculator is off, switched off, we are not able to see any of the number. So, all the memory erased when the computer is switched off. The information exists till the calculator is on. See, we have given the example of calculator. So, the calculator is the best example of RAM. And the information, whatever the information it contains, it exists till the calculator is on. As soon as we turn off the calculator, data get erased. Now next type of primary memory is ROM, and the full form of ROM is, ROM means read only memory. As the name suggests, read only means we can read this memory, we cannot save anything into it. Now see, read-only memory that holds the inbuilt information. It consists of instructions and programs fed by the manufacturer to simplify the working of computer operator. We cannot record data on ROM, only read from it. We can only read from the read-only memory. We cannot store anything on it. This is also a part of primary memory, or you can say internal memory. Now, next type of memory is secondary memory, or you can say external memory. The secondary memory is used to store data for a longer period of time. If you want to save any data which you can use after a long time, after so many days, you want to use that data, then you have to store the data into the secondary memory. So it is used to store data for a longer period of time, also called the external memory. It is also called external memory. It is required because the primary memory is not sufficient to store large amount of information. Primary memory is not enough to store large amount of data. So if we want to store large amount of data, we need an external memory, or you can say a secondary memory. I hope you all have understood this. Thank you so much.